Elephant Appreciation Day is obviously a favorite day for those of us who work with the elephants, but there's a lot more that we are learning from them while they live here. And every time that someone comes to visit them at Denver Zoo just helps support all of the research we're doing to learn more. So the elephant program here at Denver Zoo is pretty unique. We have 5 male Asian elephants, the largest all-male bachelor herd in North America. Groucho is the oldest, he's 52 years old. He's the teacher, the boss of the whole group. Then there's Bodhi, he's 18. He moved here from Columbus, was the very first male elephant we had living in Denver. Then we had Billy, who's behind me. He's 14 years old. He moved here from Ireland. Chuck and Jake are half-brothers. They moved here from Canada in 2018. Chuck is also 14, just slightly younger than Billy. And Jake is the youngest at 12. 14-year-old Chuck is the smallest at 9,000 pounds, so it's not tiny by any means. Their personalities are very unique from one another. Jake is very, very mellow. And very into snacks. He loves treats. If there is a treat somewhere to be found, he will find it. Chuck is our social butterfly. He really enjoys time spent with any of the other animals. Groucho, the oldest at 52, would spend more time alone than the youngsters. So based on what they're telling us and they're indicating every single day, we tailor their day to what they need as an individual. Asian elephants are an endangered species, so there are less than 40,000 of them worldwide. That includes the 5 males who live here in Denver. That's a really low number, a shockingly low number. And they live in range countries where their space is being reduced, and as you can imagine, they require quite a bit of space. 10, 15 years ago, there really wasn't much known about wild bull groups. A lot had been studied in the African savanna elephants, but not as much in the Asian range countries. So it's been really great to see what they're learning about Asian bulls over in India and other range countries. And we're supporting one another in what we're learning here from the males living in Denver. So it's been a really exciting relationship that we've developed over the last couple of years. So Denver Zoo built Toyota Elephant Passage with the intent to house adult male elephants. So over the 10 acres of space, you will find 5 very large, separate individual habitats that can be combined through a series of transfer gates or different hallways that can combine the entire space so animals can come and go as they please. So the amount of options we have for the elephants to engage just in their habitat alone is significant. The complexity of the exhibit allows for us to take really great care of, again, each individual in whichever state they are in from a growth perspective. So all of the elephants are trained to allow us to draw their blood voluntarily. They stand nice and still. We're able to take a blood sample to make sure that they're not starting to fight any sort of illness and making sure that they're nice and healthy. But then every other week we collect plasma in order to build up our storage in case there was an emergency. So elephants across the country and in their range countries experience a disease called EEHV. It is a form of the herpes virus, and it is potentially fatal to elephants. And one of the best ways that we can help support a zoo who is experiencing that illness in one of their elephants, or support our own elephants if they were to get sick, is by doing these plasma therapies. The collection we'll be doing today is not for an active emergency anywhere. It is so that we are able to continue building up our storage of plasma in our freezer so that we're prepared if there was to be an emergency, we could ship that anywhere across the country to help support another zoo. Everything we do is with the animals participating actively, so he always has the opportunity to leave. He is not restrained, he's not forced to stay here. He's being fed treats on the other side of the wall there. They've learned that no matter what happens, they have control in the situation. So if he doesn't want to allow it to happen, that's totally fine. And he won't get punished for not participating. We really make sure we focus on the elephants having control over their situation. So we built this little cage there for us to sit in to continue to protect ourselves while we're working with them. So this way we were able to kind of extend our protected space to be underneath them. It gives us really great access to their veins. we never go in the same space as an elephant without some sort of protection like that. So we do not share the same space with elephants. Elephants are, I think in general, have always been a favorite of a lot of people. They're very charismatic. And I think what we're doing here, learning and researching more about bull behavior, my hope is that people start to recognize similar complexities that they have as human individuals, they might recognize in these males as well and really connect with each individual that lives here in Denver. So every time someone comes to visit us here in Denver, really not only helps just the elephants here, but elephants globally.
Stay elevated by subscribing to the city's YouTube page and stay tuned to our social media channels for more content. Don't miss our new episodes of Elevating Denver, premiering each month. Thanks for watching, Denver.